Yo, what's going on, guys? Chris Bonner here, Overtime Athletes. In today's video, I want to discuss a little bit more advanced concepts in top speed. You guys, if you've watched any of my videos, you know I typically go over with you guys two different phases, the acceleration phase and then the top speed acceleration, where we're actually fighting gravity, trying to apply as much force to the ground without cycling, and then top speed where we're essentially upright in our body position and being able to cycle like we're pedaling a bicycle in order for us to essentially propel ourselves down the field or court or track. However, what I want to share with you guys today is essentially two concepts and three drills that are going to begin to support you. So the first one is just going to be a mobility exercise, okay? So first and foremost, when it comes to top speed, the biggest thing that an athlete needs to learn is essentially being able to keep the lower limb dorsiflexed, okay? And dorsiflexion is just simply, you could do this by pulling the top of the toe to the shoe here, all right? Most athletes, when they do those long recovery phases back here, they tend to go in that plantar flexion, and they're actually a lot slower when they begin to recover. We want to be able to train the athlete to stay in that dorsiflexed position the entire time and minimize that ground contact time. Not only does it do that, but dorsiflexion speeds up the recovery phase. A lot of athletes who swoop back here is usually tend to what happens is they can't go into dorsiflexion. So as they're recovering in their sprint, they want to, instead of coming here and driving off, we want to be able to strike here, recover by having that dorsiflexion, toe to the top of the shoe. And if you immediately were to just throw your toe to your top of the shoe fast, what happens? You notice the knee will bend and the hip will slightly bend, right? So that's what you're doing as you're going through the recovery phase, is you're being able to then get into dorsiflexion very fast. So for the first one, we need to start with the mobility. First drill I always like to do is you're just gonna go like this. You just go to a simple knee. What I'm trying to do is obviously get a stretch back here on those tendons. And what you're gonna do is you're just gonna drive that knee forward as much as you possibly can. If it's extremely tight or you want something a little bit more aggressive, you can easily go ahead and put a weight on it and drive that forward. Hold that for 30 seconds each side, all up to two sets or even a minute you can hold it for. So now that we've addressed the mobility, we wanna go ahead and strengthen that, okay? So we wanna strengthen that anterior tibialis. What we wanna do, a simple drill for your guys' purposes that you can immediately start to add, is just gonna be simple heel walk. So drive the toe to the top of the shoe, knee slightly bent, hip slightly bent, and you're just gonna walk just like this. You can go down 25 yards, back 25 yards. Just start adding these things into your warm-up for you to improve your top speed. Now that we've addressed the dorsiflexion from mobility and activation standpoint, we want to start to apply these to mechanical drills so that the athlete can then start to learn how to do this in their actual sprint. I like to break down three different drills that I absolutely love when it comes to top speed that also enhances this, allows me to cue this, and then it supports them in the actual cycling of it. So the first one being a straight leg pull. So with the knees slightly bent, right? You're not completely locked out. It's straight leg, but I don't like to be completely locked at the knee. You wanna go ahead and strike the ground, right? Keeping the toe to the top of the shoe and strike the ground, pulling with the glute. Essentially what this is a broken down phase of how you strike the ground when you're actually sprinting and then being able to perform that recovery phase. That's the first one. The second one is gonna be a single leg high knee. The single leg high knee, I'm looking for that triple flexion here, and I'm teaching the athlete to really make sure that that toe is to the top of the shoe, and now I'm breaking down another phase of that. So it's right here, boom. It's that same motion, except I'm just breaking down that one portion of it and teaching them to do that. Finally, the last progression is going to be the single leg cycling, where I'm actually pairing the straight leg pulls and then I'm performing a cycle. So now I'm adding that triple flexion, toe stays to the top of the shoe. I tell the athlete to step over the opposite knee, release the hamstring, and pull down utilizing that glute. So there's three drills and each one is its own progression. So again, if I'm teaching an athlete how to properly recover and be able to get into top speed, it starts with the dorsiflexion. I create mobility in the ankle. Once I do that, I strengthen it by teaching the athlete how to do it by activating their anterior tibialis. Once I have that, and I've been doing that for a little bit, I'm gonna teach an athlete through these essentially three drills, which I progress. And ultimately what I do is I start having them sprint in top speed so that they can then begin to integrate the drills that they've learned. I hope that helps. I hope it's not too much for you guys to digest. Start utilizing these drills. I'll catch you next time.
Yo, what's going on, fellas? Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in getting faster as an athlete, go ahead and click my advanced series right here where I provide you with free lessons to make you become faster. I'll see you inside.